President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. declaring his administration's full and unwavering commitment to the peace process in the Bangsamoro region in southern Philippines. Marcos graced the inauguration of the Bangsamoro Transition Authority Parliament in Cotabato City. There, he lauded the BTA's early achievements, adding he's looking forward to the fulfillment of their vision. He also urged the BTA to pass fiscal policy legislations that will promote the welfare of Bangsamoros and facilitate the conduct of elections in 2025.
No matter how impressive the gains that the Bangsamoro have already seen, I always think this is just the beginning. The path to lasting peace is always under construction. But we walk this path together, and we walk it not because it is an easy one. We walk this path together because even if it is difficult, we know that at the end of the journey is historical justice, progress, peace, stability, and the unity that our peoples and our nation have long aspired for and so rightly deserve.
BARM Interim Chief Minister Ahod Ibrahim also has high hopes the Marcos administration can help usher in lasting peace in the region.
Notwithstanding some of the significant accomplishments we have achieved so far, there are still many development and transition challenges that we need to overcome. The peace process started during your father's time. And it would be a fitting end to this long journey if we could complete the process during your administration, Mr. President. You will have our full support, and together we will make the successful implementation of the Bangsamoro peace process as one of your greatest legacies.
Meanwhile, members of the Bangsamoro Parliament unanimously re-elected lawyer Pangalinan Balindong as Speaker. ABS-CBN's Anjo Bagawisan joins us for an update. Anjo?
Yes, before President Bongbong Marcos arrived, members of the Bangsamoro Transition Authority Parliament convened to vote on their officers. Attorney Pangalinan Balindong, the Speaker of the first Bangsamoro Transition Authority Parliament from 2019 to 2022, won re-election unanimously. Balindong told the 80 parliament members in attendance that they cannot fail in their jobs as legislators because, quote, our people have suffered enough. And he added that coming together in unity is their way of repaying the blood spilled by their compatriots to achieve peace, progress, and self-determination. Let's listen into his statement.
But even though our presence here today is largely born out of political consideration, we cannot deny the fact that we are all here for a greater reason. Our cradle has brought us here to this challenging crossroad where our collective actions will decide the fate of our people for better or for worse. The only way we can repay the trust and confidence that the present administration has bestowed on us is to work hard so that our people can genuinely feel the improvement in their welfare and well-being.
Now, aside from Balindong, the Bangsamoro Transition Authority Parliament also elected 7 deputy speakers, a majority leader, a secretary general, and a sergeant at arms. Among the deputy speakers is Abdul Karim Mishwari. He's the son of the Liberation Front founder, Nomis. A rare appearance at the Transition in action to join the previous BPA parliament, that his son is now a part of it as an appearance of unity with the Moro Islamic Liberation Front, which is the ruling party of the Bangsamoro current government or interim government. Marcos had lauded the current, what he called, diverse representation of the 80-member BTA which he said spoke volumes of the group's answer toward the call for unity and shared responsibility for the region. Over half of the members of the PTA parliament were appointed by Marcos Jr. and were nominated by the ruling MILF and the rest by the national government. This second parliament, whose term will last until 2025, is expected to enact legislation such as regional, administrative, revenue, electoral, education, and civil service codes, and paves the way for the regional elections that year on 2025. From Cotabato City, Andrew Bagulisa and EBS-CBN News.
Thanks, Andrew.